Hello there, it's the coach with you here today, and this is an ultimate challenge. Let's send it down to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis for the call.
Coach, we will begin this challenge in the third quarter with 3 minutes remaining. You have a 3-point lead. Your opponent has the football on their 35-yard line. As we get set here, first and 10. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And last time we saw them go for it in kind of an unusual situation. It's not like it's a fourth quarter do or die. They went for it, didn't get it. We'll see how that affects them this go around.
Partner, I'm wondering if we're starting to see the effects of analytics coming into play here, where people are studying the number of possessions, how many times you should go for it, what position it leaves your team in. Maybe we're starting to see a little bit of that creeping into the NFL game.
Yeah, I think we've seen it in other sports, maybe into the NFL now as well. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Here's Tannehill. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Evans. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back? Essentially being a receiver downfield.
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's fourth.
The best quarterbacks that ever played the game all wanted to blend in with their teammates and be one of the guys. But sometimes you got to take modesty and put it aside. You're the franchise quarterback, the face of the team, and the guy that leads them to victory. You have to get down and protect yourself and not take hits like that.
The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complementary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Here's Eric Dickerson. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line.
An opportunity to get a drive started here at the end of the third quarter. What you're trying to do is break the game down a little bit. Don't let your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them, melt the clock down, get to the fourth quarter, try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly.
Henderson now on first and 10. They find some open field here. And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown,